Hey everybody, this is Ash with Southern Fae Witchcraft, and today I'm going to talk to you about Beltane. Now, you'll be seeing this video on Friday, and Friday night is generally when I start celebrating Beltane. Most people wait until the actual day, May the 1st, but I start April 31st at night. So we're gonna talk all about that. I'm gonna get you ready to celebrate, or if you don't want to celebrate, I'm gonna at least give you knowledge about it. So let's learn today. Now, Beltane is the celebration of the beginning of summer. It's also the celebration of the return of fertility to the land, and historically speaking, it was when the cows and other herd animals were put out to pasture. Now, generally at this time, bonfires were lit. Fire was seen as a protective force as well as a healing force. So big bonfires were lit and people would walk around them, dance around them. They would also drive their cattle through them. And this was to offer protection and healing for both the cattle and the people, and to encourage the fertility of both the cattle and the people. Because a long time ago, you needed a lot of kids to work your farm and things like that. And infant mortality rate wasn't so great back then. So you needed a lot of kids, just like you needed a lot of cows or sheep or what have you to, you know, have your meat, your wool, your leather working supplies, those types of things. So you wanted everything to multiply. And Beltane was generally a time where they celebrated fertility and hoped that by celebrating it, it would make the land fertile, the crops, the animals, all of that. Now, also they would light a very big bonfire. They put out all of the hearth fires in the area. And then they'd light a big bonfire, and then they would light pieces of wood and carry them to light the hearth fire, which everyone had in their home, to sort of symbolize a general togetherness, everyone being both connected and protected by this general big bonfire that they lit in the center of town or wherever. Now, also, Beltane was a time when, you know, courting couples got together. People would go, you know, pick flowers in the woods with their sweetheart. What happens in the woods stays in the woods. We don't know. So, they would do that. As said, people would get together and dance around the bonfire. Some people would jump over the bonfire. Don't try that at home. And if you do, don't blame me for it. I did not tell you to do that. But it was a time to come together and celebrate fertility and the beginning of summer with your community. I want to talk to you about things that you can do to celebrate Beltane as a solitary person, or even as somebody who isn't used to practicing yet. Things that you can do to kind of get in the spirit, to kind of get yourself into that mindset and get yourself in rhythm with the energy of the season right now. That's a big thing in paganism and in witchcraft. Kind of get yourself in tune with the cycle of the seasons. One of the things that is very popular to do on Beltane, and some of you may be familiar with it because of May Day celebrations, is dancing around a maypole. That's something you can do if you have a group of people. However, if you're just by yourself, there's nothing that says you can't play some, you know, some really upbeat music in your living room and dance to that. And if you live in an apartment or, you know, someplace that you can't have a bonfire, you could always light candles. You could wear or make a flower crown. You could just generally do anything for, you know, generally just do anything to symbolize fertility, whether that's creating something new, whether it's planting a garden, whether it's Even something as simple as like watering flowers or picking flowers and bringing them into your house. Also, Beltane is a huge time for the fae folk. Supposedly, during Beltane, the fae are much more active and the veil between the worlds is very thin, so that sometimes people see the fae or feel them. People leave out offerings. I generally like to leave out little bit of milk with honey or some bread with some, you know, with some butter and sugar on it. Just some nice things like here is my fae bribery, so you guys don't get into any mischief on my property. Don't do anything to harm me. Like here's your hush money. I'm only kind of kidding about that one. But it's a good time to celebrate the fae, to give them offerings, to go out berry picking, to plant gardens, to water flowers, just all kinds of things like that. And you don't need, I know a lot of people want a big coven, but you really don't need one to be able to just celebrate the holiday. You by yourself with a candle from Walmart, you know, with some flowers around it, that's enough. And if you really want to do something witchcraft related, anything, any kind of spell to boost your creativity, any kind of spell to boost your money, any kind of protection magic, any kind of love magic, all of that would be something that goes right along with the season. So any spell like that that you want to do would be best done at this time. Well, y'all, I hope you learned something today. I hope that I've encouraged you to celebrate Beltane or just given you general information on Beltane that you didn't have before. I'm Ash with Southern Fae Witchcraft. Thank you for hanging out with me today.